If you have not already, please make sure you watch my surface and underwater weight checking video prior to watching this, as a lot of the foundational knowledge you'll need is covered in that video. This video is going to be a real eye-opener for a lot of people. I'm at 25 meters and my cylinder is full, and I'm going to simulate the worst case scenario, a complete BCD failure from this depth. If you're thinking it's easy, he'll just drop his weights and he'll ascend no problem, you'd be very wrong. You actually being correctly weighted will make the difference between being able to make a safe ascent or you being stuck on the bottom and in serious trouble. The dive industry and most of the instructors in it want to have you believe that having a redundant BCD will save you, that ditching your big heavy weight belt will save you. They're wrong. You have to be correctly weighted to even stand a chance. And you don't have to take my word for it, because I'm going to prove it. Before I show you if I can ascend or not, I need to make sure you understand what correct weighting is. You can see this cylinder is full at 200 bar. We're now going to test its weight with an empty BCD. And we do this in the water, simply because that's all that matters, as we use the system in the water, not on land. These weights are very important, so remember them. When the cylinders are full, it weighs 3.3 kilos in the water. And when we use the air from the cylinder and we have our reserve pressure, which is 50 bar or 700 psi, we now have 1.3 kilos, which tells me the air weight we actually used weighs exactly 2 kilos. I'm going to show you a lung capacity test using weights. The two weights I have here combined weigh 2.4 kilos, about 1 kilo less than my side mount system when it's full, holding a 50% lung capacity. I'm actually floating around eye level, 20% lung capacity. I'm slowly descending, so I do need a little bit more weight to be correctly weighted. These tests are in a wetsuit with no BCD or cylinder. I'm now holding 3.3 kilos of weight, or an 80% lung volume. I'm floating at eye level, 50% lung volume, top of my head. When I breathe out to 20%, I'm slowly descending from the surface. Now remember, this 3.3 kilos is exactly the same as my BCD system when it's full. If I hold 100% lung volume, I'm able to stay comfortably positive on the surface without kicking my legs. The amount of usable lung volume you have will help if your BCD was to fail at depth. Now I'm going to show you a little test which proves the amount of lung volume hold I have. I have a 1.5 kilo weight here. I'm wearing my BCD system, which you've seen weighs 3.3 kilos. My total weight now, negative, is 4.8 kilos when I deflate the BCD. So I fully deflate and I'm holding 100% lung volume, as much as I can possibly breathe in. And you can see just the top of my head is bobbing with the water. So to sum up, this means 4.8 kilos is the maximum my lungs can support, and between 1 and 1.5 kilos is the absolute maximum I could be overweighted and still be safe. If you're still wondering what this means, it means don't overweight yourself, and you'll see why in the next demonstration. If I'm at 25 meters and my BCD fails, I have at least 3.5 kilos of negative buoyancy. I say at least because my wetsuit will have lost some buoyancy due to neoprene crush at depth. It's a good job I'm correctly weighted, as I will need my full usable lung volume. My cylinder is at 180 bar. It's good that I use some during the descent, as less air means more buoyancy. I'm now going to simulate the worst case scenario, a total BCD failure at 25 meters down. So my BCD is completely empty. I'm holding 80% lung volume, and you can see I'm slowly starting to descend, and I need to kick my legs gently to maintain position. Let's watch that again. So I deflate my BCD fully. I hold 80% lungs, and you can see I'm slowly dropping. I start to kick my legs, not fast, just gently. I'm now able to breathe effectively. If I kick my legs a little firmer, I'm actually able to start ascending slowly, which of course is controlled by how hard I kick. The more I rise, the easier this will become, as the pressure gets less and my suit will gain some buoyancy. In my Sidemount video series, I actually cover this same BCD failure with two cylinders and even a third stage cylinder. And believe it or not, I still prove it's possible to safely ascend from depth. The key is correct weighting. If you're overweighted, you're in trouble. I'm now communicating that at 21 meters, I can actually hold 80% lung volume and I don't need to kick. I remain neutral. Once you reach a point where you're neutral, you no longer really need the BCD to make a controlled ascent, as you can use your lung volume if you've built that skill set correctly. And remember, the shallower you go and the more air you've used from your cylinder, the less risk you have when it comes to a BCD failure. And if you were watching this thinking I was underweighted just to make this test easier, I'm afraid you'd be wrong. And to prove that, you just need to watch my end of dive weight check training videos, and you'll see that I'm always correctly weighted during every dive I make. For those of you who don't use aluminum cylinders and use steel, don't worry. You just need to make the same checks I did to find out the weight when the cylinder's empty. If this video has got you thinking that you're diving all wrong, carrying a weight belt that's too heavy, made you aware that ditching it just isn't really an option, and that you should be diving correctly weighted, then good, because you should. If you can't learn this yourself, find an instructor who can help train you. If your instructor doesn't understand how to correctly weight somebody, like I've shown in this video, change your instructor. If you've done any type of peak performance buoyancy or advanced buoyancy course and didn't learn what I showed in this video, whoever took your money and certified you should not have. The fault is with them, not you. I know this video is going to help a lot of divers, so it was actually a real pleasure to make it. I'm sure you'll want to watch it quite a few times, maybe even show it to your instructor. Good luck, safe diving.